Hello guys, welcome back to TuxWriter. In this video, we want to start a new project for post-processing, which is indeed interface tracking of tissue growth models. So in the introductory video, I showed you a moving interface like this, and I said that this is tissue growth. But what is the correlation of this moving interface to tissue growth in tissue engineering? It's related to the concept of scaffolds. I used this term scaffold in the previous video for biodegradation also a lot. But the thing is, you know the concept of scaffolds in real life, like for example for the construction of buildings. Indeed, scaffolds are some helper tools that are not part of the main entity, in this case the building, but they are there to facilitate the process of the building, of the construction. That's the same for scaffolds in tissue engineering. In tissue engineering, scaffolds are porous entities, porous fabricated things, like these shapes, and they have a wide variety of different shapes. And then biologists or the technician, they put cells on the surface of these scaffolds, and then these cells start to proliferate, they start to grow. But the thing is, some research works have shown, including this one that I have mentioned here, I have cited here, have shown that the growth rate of these cells, that they start to grow and form new tissues, this is indeed the field of tissue engineering, that the shape of these scaffolds has a great impact on the rate of growth. So by modifying it in a certain way, we can have a better and more productive growth. In order to investigate it from a computational perspective, we can study the unit cells, the repetitive unit cells that form the whole block. So they are indeed the smallest building block of these scaffolds. And in order to study the whole behavior of the scaffold and the tissue growth, we can study the tissue growth inside these unit cells, which are indeed these, the picture on the bottom. So we can simulate the behavior of these cells and cell proliferation inside these unit cells. And this leads to something like this one, this figure that I showed you in the introductory video, which is indeed the cell growth rate and cell growth, which are indeed these green zones, inside cells in the experiments and in the computational studies. So what I showed you, I mean this video, indeed is very similar to that. That imagine that this is indeed a unit cell, and then we have cells on the surrounding, on the surface, and then they start to grow. So that's the thing. In order to represent this process mathematically, we have employed two techniques here. One is the level set method, and the other one is phase field. So we want to investigate the effects of the geometry of the unit cell to the growth rate. Level set technique is the one, I'm not sure if I told you or not, but level set technique is the technique that I used in the biodegradation simulation for tracking of the moving interface. In that case, it was the corrosion front. In this case, that's indeed the surface of the growing tissue. And a level set can be applied to that very similar to the way that it can be applied to, for example, biodegradation simulation or any other multi-phase flow or those kind of stuff. But phase field is a bit different. In phase field, instead of the distance function that we have in level set, we have the phase field variable that varies from 1 to the minus 1 in a very narrow transient layer. It represents the same concepts. So if I post-process it in a way that, just clip the positive or negative part, I can see that the tissue is growing. So there is nothing new indeed to introduce you. But the thing is, the way that I have performed this phase field simulation is in a parallel scheme, in a parallelized approach, which means that the computational domain is partitioned into various subdomains. In this case, I think it is 6 subdomains. Yeah, from you can see the 6 is the way that my code has denoted the file names. But you can see, for example, for time step 0, I have from 0 to 5. And then for time step 1, I have 0 to 5 again. And it means that each of these VTU files are indeed one partition, one subdomain, one submesh of the whole mesh. And each submesh is assigned to one CPU core, for example. Just look at this from this way. Each partition is assigned to one CPU core, and in this way you can parallelize the computation and decrease the simulation time and really improve the performance. But the thing is, post-processing that is not very different from, you know, having one unified mesh, but the way that it is constructed and it's organized is a bit different. For example, the way that ParaView can understand this partition mesh is through this file, a file with PVD extension that denotes that, for example, we have 54 time steps, and each time step has 6 points. For example, you can see 6 submesh. So we have time step 0 here, again 0, 0, 0, and in 0 we have part 0 to 5. And then the same happens for time step 1, 2, to 2, and 3, and so on. So this PVD file is indeed the file that organizes all these submesh files individually. But the thing is, for the level set, everything is very similar to what we had before. So the post-processing of this level set simulation is not something new. The thing that I want to show you here is indeed the concept of this function, as I showed you for the biodegradation, this is indeed formulated in a way that the zero isocontour of this phi function is the interface. And it means that you have an evolving function over time, but as the default behavior in ParaView, if you have, as you have seen, if you post-process an animation, a time series, a sequence of time steps, the color bar, the color map is always the same. And it doesn't update automatically. And that's what it should be. That's indeed the concept of visualization for most of the times. But in some cases, some rare cases like this one, you may need the color bar to be updated. And this phi function is indeed one of that, I told you, rare cases that this is necessary. So my purpose of putting this level set simulation here was indeed that option to demonstrate that one, and also for the level set, for the phase field to demonstrate how to post-process partitioned mesh. And also, in addition to this, as I told you in the introductory video, there is another technique for simulations that I used to simulate this tissue growth, and it was indeed the physics-informed neural network technique, which is very similar to them. So the post-processing is exactly the same. That is nothing by clipping a distance function. In this case, this is phase field, so a phase field variable. But there are some changes in a way that it looks at the basic variables, at the state variables, like the coordinate system and also the time. And that's why I put that also there. So that one is also part of this interface tracking series for tissue growth. And yeah, from the next video, I will jump into ParaView and I will show you how to deal with partition mesh and also how to deal with a changing function that you need the color map to be updated along. So that's it. And yeah, see you in next video.